So we just covered lists of strings in C#. Now we're going to sort, search, and index these lists.
Mm-hmm. Let me switch back over here. I've got my tutorial on the left and Visual Studio on the right. And when we last left our heroes, we were saying names at 0. And we noted when we ran that, weird was our weird friend. That weird friend is the 0th item. So it's the, they called it the index of that.
Right.
So that's kind of weird.
Mm-hmm. So let's dive in a little bit more into indexes. It looks like our docs are saying there's another way to access an index.
Yeah. So we could go and say var and grab an index and say names dot index of. So I can actually ask the array or the list, the collection, hey, where is Kendra? What is the index of Kendra? So it's actually going to search for you in that list. And then I'll go and console.writeline index. Maybe I could even go like this and I could say found, I guess I'll just say Kendra because I've hard-coded you here, at index. Okay. Oops. Always a little syntax here and there. There we go. Let's try that. Sound like a plan?
Yeah.
And we'll get rid of our weird friend there. Control F5 or hit the play button. Found Kendra at 1. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Oops, there's Bill. And just to confirm, found Bill. I expect 2.
Right.
No.
0, 1, 2, 3. Oh.
There we go.
Okay, yeah.
Forgot about Maria there. Yeah, that's my bad. Now, what if we search for someone that doesn't exist?
Ooh, I don't know.
Let's search for Scott, who we have previously removed, right?
Yeah.
So index of Scott.
-1.
Mm-hmm. Now it says found because I wrote the word found, but it didn't actually find it, right? So that's interesting. Now we can combine that, as we see in the sample here, with an if statement. If index is not found, else. So why don't we try that? That's interesting. I'm going to copy that code in here. And I'll make it a little bit bigger. Oops. Let's put it there. So if index is -1, when an item is not found, index returns index. Else, the name, and this is interesting, look.
Is that index?
Names at index. We're going to take the index that we just grabbed. So this is the number of where Scott is, or not. And then look it up, and then print that out. So what do we think is going to happen? Is Scott in there or not? When an item is not found, index of returns -1. But if we go in here and we put in Kendra, we do it again. Ah, so let's look at that. The name, names at. That's how I think of that. So we saw that cup of tea with the less thans and greater thans. Mm-hmm. And then when you're doing a list or an array, it's at, which is the square brackets. Make sense?
Definitely. So now we know how to find the index of where something is in an array. So that's a type of searching.
Right. Let's sort. Because we've been, right now, just putting these in whatever order, right? We'll put me back in, so I'm not going to remove me right now.
Good. I wanted you to be included.
I appreciate that. And I'm going to go and have, right now, our original list. We'll change weird to new friend. We've got new friend, Scott, Kendra, and then we are going to manually or programmatically add Maria and Bill.
Sounds good.
Then we're going to spin through our list just to confirm what that looks like.
New friend, Scott, Kendra, Maria, Bill. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Looks good. Now, they're telling us sort the array. Now, this is an interesting thing because I would have thought that I would have to say names equals names.sort.
Yeah.
Right? Because I did replaces before and I did different things.
Yeah.
But in fact, sort does it in place, right? It sorts it on the spot. It doesn't make a copy of it, which, you know, might not be intuitive if you haven't seen that before. So let's see what we get when we sort our people.
Oh, cool. And it just knew to sort it alphabetically? How did we know that?
Right, that's a great question. So if we hover over sort, and we can ask that question, it says, using the default comparer.
The default comparer, of course.
Of course, the comparer. Well, so it turns out that this is a list of strings, but it could be a list of T. It could be a list of anything. So when you compare strings, you know, like, is this string less than this string? You actually have to do that. You can say, is the word Bill less than the word Kendra?
Right.
And because Bill comes before Kendra in the alphabet,
it's
Bill is less than. It's less than,
gotcha.
In air quotes. So that's the comparer, and that's how they sort.
Even without air quotes, because each character in a string does have a numerical value.
That's true.
So, like, A is a very low number. So even if the string was converted to a number, sorting them would still have, you know, smallest at the top, biggest at the bottom.
That's a really great point. Because if they, if this was, because remember we talked about strings. Strings is a friendship necklace.
Right.
It's actually a friendship bracelet or necklace of characters, or what they call chars. And those chars have numbers.
Yeah.
So yeah, you could sort the characters within a string, and that would be something as well. That's a really great point. I didn't think about that. So when we go and do something like this, we can look at a larger example. Here's a bigger example that you could mess with. And actually, you know, well, let's do this. Let's just copy that whole example.
Ooh, yeah.
And I'm just going to go and control A for all and control V for paste. And let's just kind of zoom out a little bit. Got a whole big example here. Let's run that. So we can see in the tutorial all the different things that they've done, where we've removed names, added names, sorted names, seen them move around. This is a great little example of all the different things you can do with lists of stuff. But in this case, we've only talked about strings. So let's take a break and we'll come back and we'll add other types, other stuff of T
Sounds
to
good.
Our lists.